Hi everyone, today going to be part two, weight loss supplements. So I'm going to talk about carb blockers, will be Urban Fuel, Selene, very popular, at cinnamon, psyllium husk, and calcium pyruvate. I decided to divide this video in two parts. So this video will be part two, weight loss supplements, and then I will release part three, weight loss supplement, which they are here. That's NAD Clinic, charcoal, Candida complex, laxative capsule, and 5-HTP. That's going to be in a part three. I wanted to include fat blockers. I don't have with me at the moment, but in the part two, I will talk about fat blockers too. My little disclaimer, if you will decide to take any of these supplements, talk to your doctor first, because some supplements can interfere with your current medication. In this video, I will talk from my personal experiment and what I know about these supplements. Let's start with carb blocker. I have tried this brand, Urban Fuel. The main ingredients for all the carb blockers: white kidney bean extract, Selecia reticulata, psyllium husk, and wheat germ extract. I'm not gonna go with each ingredients on all the supplements like I did in the last video, because I delete half of the video, even more. This time I'm going to talk how they affect your body and do they actually work. Carb blocker from Urban Fuel, okay, they contains black soybeans, white kidney beans, which is the one of the main ingredients, vitamin C, chitosan in small amount, that's usually a fat blocker, apple cider vinegar, and chromium. It's a very good combination, really good combination. I try this supplement for a week. I can say it's not magic pill. Carb blockers also can be used as an appetite suppressant. What carb blockers do? It restricts the body to release amylase. That's how it works. So it blocks the carb. For a week I had high carb diet and I used these supplements. And I gained 1.2 kilos per week. Then the next week I had exactly the same diet, but I didn't use the carb blocker, and I gained 1.4 kilos. So you see, it does work, but not as a magic pill, and it cannot be magic pill. Because if you decided to indulge in carbs and rely on the carb blockers, it's not going to work. It's simply not going to work. And let's talk about fat blockers. Fat blockers are good, but I don't like their side effects. I have tried Xenical like long time ago, but I don't like their side effects. So when you have a fatty meal, that fat comes out on the other end without you realizing. That's why I didn't like it. I thought, no, that's a bit just a gross. No, it's just no. But then if you eat little bit of fat, so you won't notice the difference. The only way you will notice the difference and effectiveness of Xenical, if you will eat two cheeseburger, then you would notice. And the side effect is not great. So if you are prepared and ready for it, then go for it. What it does, it blocks the fat. But don't forget, when the fat are blocked, it means the carbs, which is, can convert into fat quicker, because fats stops the carbs to be absorbed quick and convert into fat. I don't know if it makes sense, maybe I confused you a little bit, but notice that all fat-free products have high sugar, and sugar convert into fat quicker than fat convert into fat. When we eat fat, we feel fuller for longer, but when we have carb meal, then we are hungry pretty quickly. Taking Xenical as a fat blocker and relying on a Xenical, thinking, okay, it's gonna block the fat, think about the carbs. Yeah. think about the carbs. In general, fat blocker and carb blocker, it's a waste of money and time. You still need to diet. You read these reports about the carb blocker and fat blocker. All these reports say group of people took such and such supplements with controlled diet. So what's the point? So you still have to watch what you eat. And what's the point of a supplement? There isn't a supplement that can actually block the calories. Maybe there is a supplement that can block calories, but I don't know. If you know, please comment below. Maybe I don't know something and I would learn from you. Let's move to very popular Slean. What Slean does, for example, if you decide to have a high carb meal and when you take Slean, it stabilizes your sugar level, but you have to know the dosage. I have tried one capsule and I didn't see any difference, so I test my blood sugar level. I will give you as an example. When I add 40 grams of porridge with 250 ml of almond unsweetened milk with sweetness, my sugar level was 6.2. When I took Slean, my sugar level was 6. The next day I add the same meal but had 2 capsules, and then after half an hour I checked my sugar level was 5.8, and I thought, okay, that's fine. The day after I try exactly the same meal and I had 3 capsules, and then it was a bit worry because I feel a bit jittery, and I noticed that my sugar level dropped. And when I checked what was my sugar level, it was 4.2. If you decide to take Slean, go with a small dosage first. But before taking any supplements, please speak to your doctor first, as some supplements can interfere with your current medication. I also will put affiliate link at the description below. I think it's a very good supplement if you decided to have, I don't know, big pizza or McDonald's, something like high carb meal, then this would be great, but not long term. How I found this supplement? On the website where I bought SARMs, I saw Slean and I thought, wow, I like the ingredients and let me try. And the website you can see on the screen. So Slean, made by Dr. Tony Hughes. Dr. Tony Hughes come up with the supplement Slean. I don't know why they call him doctor, he's a lawyer, but I like his physique, he looks great.
And bodybuilding pioneer, and today I'm gonna answer your questions about sugar they uptake into their muscles, which then translates into better performance and lower body fat.
Dr. Tony Hughes, he experimented a lot with the supplement. Look at his physique, he looks amazing, really good body shape. But then again, I wouldn't suggest to take all sorts of supplements and do the injections and trial like he does. But then I experiment as well with the supplements, but not as a serious supplements like he does. Then we move to calcium pyruvate. I talked about these supplements in one of my videos. It's very good supplements. I've tried them for 2 weeks and they do work. Calcium pyruvate did suppress my appetite, but not kind of suppressing that you don't want to eat, but you don't have this crazy hunger. So you're kind of hungry, but you can control your hunger. Calcium pyruvate is said to promote weight loss by boosting fat breakdown in the body. Pyruvate is involved in the metabolic cycle to produce energy in your body. So theoretically, it makes sense that taking as a supplement could increase the amount of energy and fat burn you experience. When I took calcium pyruvate, I did notice that I lost a little bit more fat, but I took them for 2 weeks. You would ask, will I continue taking them? Probably yes, but not long term. Maybe 2 weeks and then I would forget about them. Maybe 3 weeks and then I would forget. Ideally, you can take calcium pyruvate for 6 weeks and then give yourself a break. I read a couple of reports on calcium pyruvate that it can give you a diarrhea, gas, bloatiness, but I didn't have any of this. So it's very safe and it doesn't have serious side effects. I will add the link at the description below. If you are new to my channel, please press like and subscribe. Don't forget to press the little red bell button so you can see notification every time I release new video. Have you pressed it? Just press it there, just there. Just there. Here we go. You did it. You did it. Okay, let's move to psyllium husk. I use psyllium husk quite a lot in my porridge, pancakes, or when I bake something for kids. So I use it quite a lot. It's very good for your gut. When you add psyllium husk in your diet, you will have more butyric acid in your poo, which is good. It helps the good gut bacteria to thrive. I would highly recommend to use psyllium husk a little bit in your pancakes or in your porridge. You don't need much. You can add half a teaspoon when you're making pancakes or add in your porridge. If you decide to take psyllium husk, talk to your doctor first. I also want to say, when you decide to take psyllium husk, don't take any multivitamins or any supplements or certain medication, because psyllium husk binds it and blocks the absorption. So basically you reduce the effectiveness of whatever supplements you take. So I would highly recommend psyllium husk. Add to your baking. I add psyllium husk into my protein shake. For example, when we bake biscuits with kids, so I would add a little bit. It's a good source of fiber, and as I said, it increases your butyric acid in your poo, which is a very, very good sign. Now we move to cinnamon. You can hear it, I used quite a lot. I like cinnamon taste, and I add to my coffees, and in general I think it's a great supplement, especially if you have PCOS, that's for women, or if you struggle with candida. So I would highly recommend cinnamon. But my purpose of taking cinnamon is to stabilize the sugar. Again, I don't take it often. Cinnamon is great if you are on candida detox, for example, or if you want just to stabilize your sugar. In general, cinnamon is very, very good herb. So adding to your diet, to your hot drinks, it's the best. And you cannot overdose with cinnamon like as you can with Slyn. Slyn can drastically reduce your sugar level if you take high dose. Whether with cinnamon, you cannot overdose. But again, speak to your doctor first. But I tried to take 4 capsules and it didn't make me feel jittery or shaky or something. No, it didn't. It's just a good herb to add to your supplement stack. If you have any questions about these supplements, please comment below. And if you like this video, please press like. So overall, what I would recommend if you decide to take them, definitely psyllium husk. You can add to your food, like I said. Cinnamon is very good to take occasionally. It's just good for your health. Carb blocker, I will put it there. Calcium pyruvate can suppress your appetite and burn a little bit more fat. And it does give you energy as well. That's what I noticed. It gives you a bit of hype. Little bit, not much, little bit. And with Slyn, that's for bodybuilders, I would suggest. When they need to lose weight quickly, very quickly, then I would say go for Slyn. But again, be careful with dosage. I will add the video of Dr. Huge so you can see the full details how he used the Slyn. He also said in his video that he eats donuts.
The 8th wonder of the world on social media. How do I eat foods like this and maintain this body composition and health?
Don't believe that. Just don't believe that. It's just a good sales, it's good promotion. So in reality, it doesn't work like this. You can take Slyn for 4 weeks, I don't know, 3 weeks, however he suggests. But don't think that by taking Slyn, you're gonna look like him. It's not gonna work. I hope you like this video. I also want to say thank you to all of my subscribers and big thank you for watching my videos. If you are new to my channel, please don't forget to press like and subscribe, and you see that little red bell button. Press that too, please, so you receive notification every time I release new video. So my part 3 video going to be about these supplements. It's going to be interesting. Look after yourself, look after your health. Your health is your wealth. And I will see you in 2 days. Bye.